All right, today we're going to talk about the three waves of volunteers. That's a Dolores canon explanation of those beings coming here. You might be one. We're going to talk about that, but I'm going to talk about something new that I got a major download with, and that is earth angels. Are you an earth angel? Well, I'll tell you what that entails and how it's different from the waves of volunteers. You can see if you're one, and if you're not, you can graduate. Yeah, we're going to talk about that right now. Let's go. Welcome to Landria Onkka on YouTube, here to help you break through those fears. Live an amazing, beautiful life. Raise your frequency. One light being at a time, just you. You only have to do it with one being, because when you do that, you affect all others, because we are all a one. And somebody said that they looked into my eyes, and you're probably thinking, I'm looking at me. Yeah, that happened to me with Eckhart Tolle, and I actually did one of these. I was looking at him, freaky kind of thing, live, and he actually said at that moment, you probably think you're looking at yourself. So, when you look at others, you are looking at yourself. I'm looking at me. Why? All you're seeing is just a facade of an expression of you, one energy. We can't comprehend that. So we're going to talk today about something I think you might be able to comprehend. It's something Dolores Cannon came up with, but I'm going to share with you where she got this from. You know, Dolores Cannon, I am actually a quantum healing hypnosis technique hypnotist trained by Dolores Cannon. Now, what she made clear to everyone is she does not channel. She's not getting downloads. She is totally separate from the information she gets. She actually gets it from the higher beings that speak through her subjects, her hypnosis subjects, who she works with, who then come in and decide they want to talk to Dolores. And they have dictated all of her books. Yeah, that's where she's getting all this information from. So she makes it very clear she's not a channel. Well, it doesn't mean you can't be getting all kinds of information. Whether you're channeling through someone else and getting information, or you're channeling yourself, or you gotta be careful with that, or you're just getting downloads and you're fully present when that happens. Everyone has the ability to do that. Even your intuition is part of a download, so to speak. It's a connection to that field out there. So we have to talk about what's going on planet Earth. We are at a critical, I call it the tipping point. Now, I did a video called the Nexus Points. We're at a Nexus Point. Those are events in time that will happen. In other words, all these other things can happen, and that there's a cycles that go through where, boom, there's an event. Now, ours is not a very pleasant event, because we've created density and lower frequencies have culminated into an event that was pretty cataclysmic. It affected our health. It could have been any number of things. So we have the ability at these points to make different choices than we have. And so far, every time we hit one of these, we all just turn on each other and argue, and we just don't change anything. You know, our total way of living here has been really in toward the dark side, right? Well, that's been going on for a very long time. Now, I'm going to ask you a question, because there's a difference between the waves of volunteers and earth angels. Waves of volunteers are those who, because Earth is so stuck in density, and those reincarnating and coming back aren't mastering things, aren't raising their frequency. They might a little bit, but not pulling out. And the culmination of these experiences, these entities, all of us are a part of the one, all these energy fields have been low. So in other words, we are doing more destruction than good. We're not pulling out. So because we directly affect the entire universe, the universe, unlike ourselves, is on a much higher level. So therefore, all the beings out there feel that energy field. They're affected directly, just like an empath would be. They're directly affected. And that's why I said aliens have a major concern. They want to see us do well, because when we go into awakening, we go into a high state of frequency that is congruent with theirs, and everybody's singing in La La Land and everything's wonderful. Right now, it's like how we feel, right? You may be, you know, meditating, you're waking, all this stuff, but you still have to look at the pain here. Well, they're feeling the same way. So there is a directive that says no one can interfere with free will, because the whole purpose of planet Earth is a master teaching classroom. It's a master class. In other words, you're coming to the most challenging of places, and you can accelerate your frequency and awakening massively here. Over there, you know, you don't know what pain is. You don't know what's a challenge over there, right? You think of something, it shows up, you learn. But here, because we lost touch with our, let's just say, our oneness, our light, and we don't recognize it, we take this very seriously, and we connect to and believe the material world, which is a hologram created for us so that we can learn all these cray-cray lessons. Fear. There's no fear on the other side. Even if you're on a lower frequency, there's no fear. There might be some discomfort if you're low frequency, but no fear, not like we experience here. Loss, sadness, all those things are human, and so we have to be humans in order to go through that. Even Christ experienced things. He got angry, and he lost his faith, right? When he was out in the desert, Father, you've forsaken me. He doubted. So he had to go through, as this super, you know, light being, still had experience being human. He had to go through all of that. So we're no different. We're just maybe not coming here on that level, right? But I want to share something with you. Because no one can interfere with the classroom here, nobody can come in and do your homework for you or just give you an A. You have to do it yourself. That's how it works. So even your angels, guardians, and those on the other side who have agreed to be there and help guide us, oversee us, protect us sometimes, cannot interfere with your free will, your path. Now, if sometimes people are saved from accidents and, you know, all this stuff goes on, an angel saved me, because you already in advance agreed that you weren't going to leave the planet until you accomplished certain things. So maybe you are experiencing stuff that's going on that allows you to stay here and complete your mission. That's not interference. That is them going through with what you agreed to in advance. So it's your will. Angels cannot just change things for you. So if you pray for something, the reason it doesn't come is because you have the power to do it yourself, and they can assist you in that. So what I want to share with you today is you have to understand that whole structure. The holographic universe cannot work unless we are allowed to play it out as our roles that we chose and the lessons we chose. To not complete those would interfere, and we'd have to go off somewhere and do it. So do it now. Master it. However, because we haven't, there are beings that have been humans before, and some who've been, you know, aliens or other forms on other planets, all kinds of energy fields, you know, light beings, decided there was a big old meeting. I'm sure it was the Council of Nine or whoever it is. I met one of them. Have come to overseen the universe, overseen the galaxies, came together and said, we're on a path of destruction here, and that's going to affect everyone. We cannot interfere. How do we help planet Earth pull out of this? By their choice, but we have to give them a boost without interfering. So they decided to send down higher frequency beings who are going to be on a mission to basically boost the frequency here without interfering, because we know that that does make a difference, right? So light beings volunteered and said, I'll go down. Now here's what Dolores shared, is that there are waves. The first wave that came down, the first ones, they would be much older right now. And they had to pave the way. It was very difficult because they came on a super dense planet, a very materialistic planet that didn't have YouTube spiritual teachers and all that stuff. You know, people were getting locked up if they talked about this stuff, right? The second wave, probably another decade later or so maybe, came in. And so they once again are more of the people that you'll see making a difference. Not necessarily spiritual teachers, but those who you can tell that they have a much higher frequency naturally, probably born that way, came down here. They don't know that they're volunteers, by the way. And here's why. Because the only way we can raise the frequency without interfering is to be a human. We have to believe we're humans so we can interact as humans. We can't interfere up here. As humans, we're going through the same stuff. So now we can make choices as humans, not knowing that we're volunteers, and make differences on the planet with other people and raise our own frequency like Christ did, going through the whole human experience to demonstrate what can be done. Now, there's a third wave of volunteers, and they're younger, and then I don't know what happens after that. You know, the people call star seeds, whatever. I think a lot of parents like to think their kid's a star seed, and let's just face it, kids are just a lot more in tune than adults, and especially those coming in now who see the damage that the adults have done. But the three waves have some characteristics. They usually aren't married or have been married but aren't. Generally, they probably get divorced. They usually work for themselves, and a lot of them work from home. This is according to Dolores Cannon. Most of them don't have kids. They might have a kid, but you know, what's that situation? Probably not. And you know, there's a few other characteristics. I'll think of them. But that's generally what's happening. The reason they don't have kids and they work independently and all these other things is because they don't want to have attachment or karma attachment to the planet. So if you have a child, you are karmically, physically, energetically attached to that child. That's part of you, right? And whatever happens with that child, you're going to be connected to that. And they avoid that, right? They don't want to do that. So true waivers will, you know, have these characteristics. Now, you might say, well, you know, I don't apply, but I think I'm a waiver. A lot of people think they're waivers, but it doesn't mean you are in a higher frequency that agreed to come down. So it's not that cut and dry. And even Dolores Cannon later on said, we need to, you know, open this up. It's not, you know, here's the age group and this age group and this age group. Well, I'm going to tell you what's happening right now because this is a major download I got. There are earth angels that came here, have been coming here, and more here than ever before. Because there was a call to come up to the higher realms of light beings to come in with super high frequencies and populate the planet just like the waivers do, but they will never have kids. They will never want kids. They are not attached to the planet. They're very uncomfortable here. They come in and people know they're different. Even as a child, the parents will know that they're different. Something's just different about the kid. And the earth angels are already in the high frequency with one mission and one mission alone. And that is to raise the frequency in pretty much everything they do. They still experience being human, but they have a pretty good understanding that that's not really the core of what they're from. Earth angels pretty much know that they come from something else. And they may not talk about it. They may not be clear on it. Some of them are very clear on it. Some of them have memories of not being here and being in other places. Some of them have been physical beings in other places, but have accomplished great feats in order to accelerate to the light being status. So if they were in a material form of some kind, they were a major master of those classes. They did not have to come down, but they volunteered to go through the pain of being a human in order to help the planet accelerate and pull out of the darkness. And that is to love the darkness. Yeah, I know. Doesn't sound right, does it? To love the darkness. Battery change. Boy, I'm blowing through some batteries. Earth angels will have special abilities. The waivers may not. They will just be very peaceful, loving, caring people, giving, that feel not so attached to the earth, but they may not even know their purpose, but they know that they're different, and they desire for awakening for the planet, and they work on it for themselves. Earth angels are already there, and they still experience being a human. They do cray-cray stuff too, but earth angels are very clear on things and do have high intuition abilities, psychic abilities of some kind. They definitely get messages from other beings, and they have the ability to manifest. So I'm going to share something with you. I did this in my Miracle Circle class, one of the lessons. We actually start to learn to control this, to get out in check, go to a higher frequency, because we don't manifest on a low frequency in the Miracle Circle. And I actually have you do an exercise where we manifest something. So I thought, well, I'm going to do it myself. So the first thing I wanted to manifest was a feather. And I went for a walk, and I wanted a black feather. By the way, I've not seen a feather, I don't know, maybe in years. All right, I found my feather, and then I said, well, let me manifest a dime. When's the last time you saw change just laying around? Just found it. Okay, this is simple stuff you can do. You have abilities. Earth angels are here to raise the frequency, and we are okay. And there's a lot of them here, by the way. It's not like, oh, there's a dozen on the planet. They are coming down, and we are balancing out this density. No matter what the darkness does, you can go into a golden era. There's a beautiful new earth happening, will happen. It has to happen. Nothing can stop it. Nothing can stop it, because light has ultimate power. This is the game. It's only an illusion. So even when we leave here, guess what? We don't go over and, the dark side has power over there. That's still part of the illusion that they're going to have to deal with and learn that maybe they should have been nicer and may have to come back and suffer some consequences of greed or, you know, doing things harmful for money or whatever it is. You have to start making higher decisions. So, are you an earth angel? Maybe you feel like, I'm not a waver, and no kids, probably work for yourself at home. Never wanted kids. You have abilities. You know you're different. You have visions, things like that, downloads, and you feel very uncomfortable on this planet. In fact, you don't even think of yourself as a human being, and you can't even relate to humans. You think it's sort of, you know, insane. It's like being in a, you know, insane house where people are walking around talking cray-cray stuff, and you're going, what is this? And so maybe you relate to this. I'll be interested to see what you guys have to say. I think there's a lot of you out there. All right, so what does that mean? We have assistance, but no interference. That means we have to do the work. Humans have to do the work. The frequency is leveling up. It's here. We are going into a golden era. I'm telling you right now, our future is amazing and beautiful. There will be people on the planet who will never experience it, because you do control your individual reality. It's endless. Every reality is individual in the ultimate, you know, the collective, and that affects the universe. So they want everybody to go to that high frequency. They desire everybody to, and they're cheering us on. And I think that's why they're showing themselves. Aliens are showing themselves, and orbs and angels and fairies are all showing up now. It's like, you know, we're all here. We're here because the veil is starting to lift, and we're starting to see that beautiful, endless, wonderful, imaginative, creative world that the One does. The One just creates and expands. Let's do it at a high frequency. You've got to do your job. You can do it. Hang in there with me. I know you can do this. I am going to promise you it's so worth it. Every thought, every time you have a judgment, stop yourself and say, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. That is not what I choose. I send my light and love instead. Even to the biggest jackass walking to the planet. Can you do that? Christ did that. Oh, but you're not going to do it? Great. Stay here in 3D. It's not going to be much fun. I promise you that. I had a total shift today, and I want to share that with you. I've been feeling it, and today it was like gangbusters. Next video coming out. stay tuned. I'm going to share with you something that's going on the planet right now. I have a video about a soft shift. We've been in a soft shift, but something right now is happening. I'm going to share that with you. You are in good hands, but if you aren't an earth angel or a waver, you've got the toughest job of all, and that is to pull out of that depths of poor little me. Everybody's hurting me. I'm a victim. Blah, blah, blah. You know? Shut your pie hole. Spiritual butt kick. Hey, you came to my channel. What did you expect? All right, so please subscribe. Share these. Share the good news that there is assistance here without breaking the rules. Guys are brilliant. They think of everything. All right. You guys, you know this is my training for online businesses. Start doing things for a living that are good for the planet. Make decisions. Educate yourself. Empower yourself. Quit going, oh, I'm going to get fired from my job if I can do. All right. Just do. Make a decision. Maybe the planet is saying, yeah, what is that job? You're miserable. You know, what are they going to tell you to do something? Don't, if you don't want to do it, don't do it, but start making independent decisions and don't blame anybody else because we're shifting out of those jobs. You know what the black community did when they were told to sit in the back of the bus? They stopped using the bus. Oops. Buses were out of business. Start using your noggin, people. We are absolutely in control of a positive earth and we do not have to punish anybody or put anybody out of business. We're just going to make higher choices, right? Nobody's to blame. We get to do that. Bless everyone. They're our best teachers, all right? Come on over. Manifest Anything's free. Down in the description, you'll get a free app, mobile app, when you sign up. And you'll get all kinds of offers for my classes. If you are still in fear, I have a very inexpensive course, masterclass, called Move Past Fear. Or you can join the Miracle Circle. It's $29.95 a month. I made it so cheap, so cheap. And so it includes a whole month of online course. And then you get a live session with me and a recording of a different session. I don't know what else to do for you, right? I don't know what else to do. Please, please share these. What you can do to help me, to help you, help me help you, is to get subscribers on here. We raise the frequency when people are focused on positive news, not the stuff out there. That's how it works. Where's your focus, my friend? Your whole, perfect, strong, loving, harmonious, and happy, beautiful, perfect, I don't know, whatever. Anyways, that's from the Master Key System. That's what I teach every month. That saying, that mantra, healed somebody who was supposed to die and cured them from being a cripple his whole life. You know what? Thoughts are things. You have thoughts, you can create anything you desire because you're the one. Unconditional love, my friend. Namaste.